Okay, so now we're actually going to get into the whole idea of matrices and MATLAB and why MATLAB is actually amazing. So MATLAB stands for matrix, I should do it like this, laboratory. So actually MATLAB is optimized to do things in matrices. So if you are just doing things like x equals 3 plus 5, you really should just be doing Python like it's like elementary school again. Really the power is whenever you're doing stuff in matrices. So MATLAB is amazing. It is optimized to do everything. And so matrices are like how you express large amounts of data, right? So, you know, if you want to express any amount of data in a matrix or an array, I'm going to use the word matrix to refer to an array, so like a one-dimensional matrix. We might call an array in a math class. I'm just going to call it a matrix. Like blah, 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 blah. That's just going to be a matrix. So the way that we might do that is if we want to insert... I'm assuming we can do that here. Matrices, there's a matrice thingy. Drip, 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 drip. A 1 by 5, you know, a 3, 5, 6, 2, 1. I'm just doing this so you know what I'm doing. All right, so if, in case you haven't done math in a long time, if you have something that looks like this, it looks exactly the same in MATLAB. I don't really need to show it, but if you have something a little bit more complicated, in so if I have something a little bit more complicated, like I'll just do them in order so it's easy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 in MATLAB. If I want to put that into here, you come all the way down here. Nobody cares what's in the command window. I meant to put an equal sign there. If I have something like this here, then in MATLAB, I can go A is, you're gonna use square brackets to indicate a matrix. So it's 1, 2, 3. Now if you want, you can go, and I just like to put spaces to make it all kind of match. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Does it really matter that they don't line up? No, MATLAB is still gonna give me a 4 by 3 matrix. Now it's telling you it's 4 by 3 matrix. So this is a 4 by 3 matrix because it has 4 rows and 3 columns. Okay, so it's 4 rows, 4 lefty-righties, and 3 columns, which is, columns are the uppy-downies. Okay, so the 3 uppy-downies, 4 lefty-righties. So it's a 4 by 3 matrix. MATLAB tells you it's a 4 by 3 matrix, which is pretty great. So you can write it like this, and it's fantastic. And again, it doesn't have to line up. Sometimes we like things to line up just to make it a little bit easier to see. So you can make it pretty if you want to. And remember, you can add a, oops, I'm Pythoning in my head. You can make the numbers line, oops, I can't spell. If you want to make it pretty, but you don't have to. So if you just like, if 6 is kind of like its own thing, it still works, okay? There's other ways you can do it. You can also say 1, 2, 3, semicolon, 4, 5, 6, semicolon, 7, 8, 9, semicolon, 10, 11, 12. So if you've used a T89, this is just like, dang it. Stupid Python. Like TI-89. So if you have a TI-89 calculator, that's the exact same way you would do it there. If you hate life, you can do it in multiple ways. You can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then you can be like 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and you get the exact same thing. So all those different ways get, oh, why did I do that? All those different, 10, 11, I think I clicked a button, 12, all those different ways getting the exact same answer. Now, what I accidentally did just there is I hit this little button off to the side that says view the variable. So if I want to view the variable, oh, that's not what I hit. I hit a different number. This is something totally different. I clicked it, to make it look like a table, to make it a little bit easier. I guess I could go and I could change things if I wanted. Do I want to play with this yet? No, I don't think I can change anything. I'm just gonna pretend that didn't happen. I don't know. It's kind of bothering me. I guess that's if I wanted to, if I had a huge matrix, I guess that could be useful. So let's, I'm gonna do something that's gonna look weird. Let's go rand. Okay, you're gonna freak out and that's okay. You're like, is it okay though? Let's go rand 10 by 12. Actually, we're gonna round the rand 10 by 12 times 10, like that, and see what we get. Okay, so now we got a whole bunch. So I guess what that would be kind of useful for is if I was like, oh, I don't know what this one is, rather than having to count, I could do that and I could be like, oh, so that element right there is at 6, 10. And so that actually brings us to a great little thing is if I wanted to access that element just by itself, I could be like, I want to access, I already forgot which one I picked. This number here, it's at row 6, column 10. So I want B at row 6, column 10. And row 6, column 10. Well, now it's a 1 because it's redoing the random numbers over and over again. I guess that's fine. It's just redoing the random numbers. So now 6, column 10 is 1. If I run it again, 6, column 10, sorry, row 6, column 10 is again, now it's 9. So it's going to change every time because I'm just randomly putting together numbers. So it's kind of cool. So this is how you access, so we'll say this, dang it. This is how you access individual values in a matrix. So that's kind of cool. Let me put in, like if you wanted to go do this up here on just like a simple one, like X here. Like if I just wanted to find the third value of X, I wouldn't have to do, since it's just a single, what do you call it? It's a one-dimensional or two-dimensional, it's only a one-dimensional array, then just X at 3. So I think in Python, if you took Python, you did it like this, it does not like that. You need to use parentheses, so you're doing X at the third location. So that's how you access the individual values in a matrix. So if I wanted to, I could actually change that value. I'm still doing it. I could actually change that value. This process. By doing this, I could say, well, so B is going to be these random numbers, but for some reason, it's really important to me that the value at 6, 10 is whatever, but the value at, I don't know, 4, 5 is equal to 999. So I'm going to run all this again, and you're going to see that prior to this, the value at 4, 5 was 4. And now it is 999, okay? So yeah, just as many times as I run this over and over and over again, yeah, I'm gonna get different answers for that random thing. But yeah, I mean, matrices are great. This is exactly what MATLAB was meant to do. Something I should say is if I try to access a value of this matrix, thank you, that doesn't exist, like if I try to go, well, what is column 12 or row 12 column 10, it's going to be like, what's your problem? So it's going to error out. This is weird. Some programming languages, like the closer you get to machine language, like C will just give you a fake number because it'll be like, oh, well, she must know what she's talking about. And it'll just be like, here's a piece of data from who knows when, from the last time someone used this computer. It'll give you nonsense data. MATLAB has the decency to tell you that you're trying to access information that's not there. Something I've kind of skipped over that I haven't really mentioned, but you can kind of tell. If I click here, you see how everything starts at ones. If you program in other languages, some matrices and things index at zero, and that's because they are made by the devil. And the devil is indexing at zero.
No, it's really not. It's just, I don't like it. So if you try to go zero, zero, it's going to yell at you and be like, you can't do that. You have to, so the first element is at 1, 1, not 0, 0. So you have to go, if you want to do the last one, you have to go all the way to 10, all the way to 12. There's other ways to get there, but if I go to 13, it's gonna give me an error. If I try to go to 11, it's gonna give me an error. So just something like that to keep in mind. And then it's kind of fun to remember that anything that you can do to, here, I'm gonna go ahead and put this back to, so here, as I'm making notes for myself, if I go B, 12, 10, I'll say this, dang it. This gives an error, this gives an error because the matrix only has 12, 10 rows, not 12. Okay, so that's fun.